In multi-channel devices, every single channel is separately converted into digital by the microcontroller, and the total weight is calculated by software. This makes more information available with respect to traditional analog systems. At startup, the system automatically detects the connected load cell. You can also trigger the auto-detect with the menu item cell channel inside the menu calib. I press Enter. It is now checking the channels. Now it says Auto 6 because it detected 6 connected load cells. If you press Enter now, you will save the current selection and make it permanent. This has got an advantage. If a load cell breaks down while the system is off, you will get an error message at the next startup. With the auto-detect, you will not, because the system discards the channels that are not good at startup. So I press Enter to save the current selection, and I go back to the wait. Now I show you that if I disconnect one of the wires or one load cell, I will get an error. Let's see it. Okay, you see RCL4. So you know which load cell has generated the error. Okay, now I put the wire back. And the error has gone. You can easily visualize the load distribution among the channels with the key test. You can see that the weight is quite equally distributed. Here you have the channels from 1 to 6, then 7 and 8 are off. And for each channel you have the percentage of load. If I put a weight on the platform, you can see that the distribution changes. Let's see it. You see that the load cell distribution is changing, and load cell 5 is now the most loaded one. Okay, I remove the weight and go back to the weight. Then you have some more advanced diagnostic features. There is a dedicated menu called Diag. Here you are. I will show you an example. If I set OAuth 0 to yes, I enable a diagnostic on 0. So, when I set the weight to 0, the system stores the weight distribution. If the weight goes to 0 again with a different weight distribution, I will get an error. To simulate it, I will now put a mass in a certain position. And do a calibration 0. Enter. The system asks if I want to save this weight distribution. I select yes and confirm with enter. Then enter again. Back to the weight. Then I add another mass to move the weight away from 0. And then I remove the first one. I will see 0 again, but I will get an error RDiag because the system senses that the weight distribution has changed. This might reveal mechanical errors on the system. The same alarm system can apply to load values different from zero, but it works only with systems where the load distribution in the container is repeatable, for example liquids, and you want to monitor that this distribution stays always the same, because if it changes, it can mean that there are problems. The last thing I want to show you is the event logger. The device stores the last 50 events that happened to the system, including errors on the weight, calibration and equalizations done, with additional information. This can be very useful if you get an error and you don't understand where it has come from. Let's see. There is a menu item called Event. And with this EV, you can see the log. For example, here we see that the last event was a diagnostics error.